Mayor Villaraigosa, great to talk to you. I want to talk about your new role as the new infrastructure czar here in the state of California. What will you be doing in this position?
First of all, it's a real honor to be back serving my state, the state my grandpa came to more than 100 years ago. What will we be doing? Breaking glass, as the governor said. I love that metaphor, because I think the best way for us to move to the infrastructure of the 21st century is to break some glass. It takes too long to build in this state. It costs too much to build in this state. And with the resources that we're getting from the federal government, it would be political malpractice and not to leverage what we're doing to make some changes, to build faster, to build less expensively, to accelerate projects, to focus on projects that have a double, triple, and quadruple bottom line. What do I mean by that? I mean, like a transportation project, for instance, a light rail line or subway or Caltrain that has transit-oriented development, housing along that corridor that is dealing with climate change because you're taking cars off the road and moving people, that is taking you to a destination that could be a destination for economic development. That's what I'm talking about. Using the fact that California is putting up their own money, we're not just looking at the federal government with a handout, we're putting up our own money. So we have to get at the front of the line when it comes to federal money, because that's the way to expand that pool of money exponentially. That's what I did as mayor of Los Angeles. I think the governor said something to the effect that during the campaign trail, he couldn't say that he got more money for his city than I did. And what we did was we thought out of the box. We broke the glass. And that's what I want to do in this job.
All right, so this is a bit of an unlikely partnership. Let's be honest here. You ran against the governor in 2018. You've been critical of him during the pandemic, especially when it came to the opening of schools. So it caught some people by surprise that you would be working together. So how did the pitch go? How did he get you to want to take this job?
First of all, I also endorsed him the night of. I've always said when you lose, lose big, be a big person. When you win, win small, be a big person. And he won, and he's been a big person. We actually have a much better relationship than the media would like to portray. I respect the governor and the work that he's doing. We've not always agreed, but you know, he's married, and when you know, I've been married, and I can tell you, you may love your spouse, but you don't agree with them on everything. And I think what we do recognize that this is the Golden State, and we want to restore the luster. We want this to be about leveraging middle-class jobs. And so what he pitched was, hey, I think this would be fun, and it'd be an opportunity for us to work together. And I think that, you know, we're consonant on what the priorities ought to be. So it wasn't, an excessive pitch. It was just, I know you want to serve, and I think this is an area where you, you know, fits like a glove, a position that fits like a glove, and I said yes.
Okay.
That was easy. That was easy.
So you obviously were mayor of Los Angeles, served in the state house here in Sacramento. You served as assembly speaker as well. You know it's difficult to get
You're
stuff done.
You're trying to stay at home.
Yes. No, not at all.
I've
not
been
at
around
all.
The block. I've been around
yeah.
the block.
You've seen a thing. You've seen a thing or two. So, but you know it's difficult to build here in the state of California. There's a lot of regulation, a lot of red tape, especially if you're talking high-speed rail, the Delta tunnels. Those were big projects that Governor Brown wanted to get done that have sat idle. So how are you going to bypass a lot of the environmentalists and this red tape and the costs that you mentioned too?
Well, first of all, you know, we accelerated permitting to build a football stadium in Los Angeles. Why can't we do that for high-speed rail? Why can't we do that for Caltrain? Why can't we do that at the Port of Los Angeles and Long Beach? The fact of the matter is, we need to cut red tape. We need to shorten the time it takes to build these projects. And I think the governor is clear that we have to do that. Now, how do you do it? You got to bring people together. You got to say, look, we can protect the environment. We can protect, the California values, if you will, while at the same and policy, while at the same time, cutting red tape. That ought to be something we're all for. So that it costs less to build the project. We may not be successful everywhere, but it's certainly my intention. That's what I'm going to start out doing. And as I said to the governor, I love your metaphor. I'm ready to break the glass. I'm ready to be responsible for breaking the glass. But I know you have to bring people together. That means labor and business and the environmentalists and communities. But you also got to be decisive and not afraid to make a decision. I wasn't the most popular guy when I left the mayorship. I think I got a 58% approval rating when I left, which means half the people liked me and half the people didn't. But nobody said I wasn't able to make a decision. And I was afraid that I wasn't afraid to do my job. And he's asked me to do a big job, and I'm ready to do it.
All right, you talked about bringing people together. Does that mean we're going to be seeing more of you in the state capitol nowadays?
It's more in the state capitol, but I'm also going to be on the road. I'm going to visit every big city, the 13 big cities and more. I'm going to meet with experts and, asking the mayors about their priorities, asking the various transportation commissions, the local ones, the same, looking at energy, water, looking at all of the things, broadband, all of the things that make up infrastructure.
All right, I want to pivot now and talk about the election in November. Not a lot of excitement surrounding the statewide elections. We pretty much know how those outcomes are going to be. But
The governor's going to get reelected.
Yes, that we can say that today. But I want to ask you about the L.A. mayor's race, because that's one that's being closely watched, not only in your town there, but also across the country, especially because of the two figures, Rick Caruso and Karen Bass, and the money that's being spent. You are a prolific supporter of Karen Bass. In one tweet, you said, "We need a leader who has worked her entire life to lift up all of our communities." So why will Karen Bass be the best person, the best choice for voters to be the next mayor of Los Angeles?
You know, it's often said that the mayor of Los Angeles is not a powerful position. I never found that to be true. But partly because I worked it. I was in every single community. I brought people together, and I think that's what she's going to do. She's done it her whole life. You know, we were talking about being around the block, Nikki. I've known her 49 years. I've worked with her the entire time. I encouraged her to run for speaker. She supported me when I first ran for the assembly. We've worked together to get rid of liquor stores and motels that proliferate the poorer communities, to make investments in infrastructure, schools in those communities. We've been tied at the hip as activists initially and then as elected leaders. And I've seen her make the tough calls when she was speaker working with Governor Schwarzenegger during the toughest recession. I know, because I was mayor at that time. And she has the wherewithal to do that. You know, this isn't a job where you just declare, I'm the mayor and I will rid the city of homelessness and crime will go down dramatically. I know a little bit about that. I took down crime we were worse than Chicago, from the most dangerous big city in the country to, along with New York, the safest big city in the country. So I know a little bit about that. And she's got the wherewithal, the talent, the experience, and the commitment that you need to get the job done. This is not a job where you do it part-time, where you make a declaration and it will be true. You're not a CEO. You're really a cheerleader. You're a motivator. You're a convener. And you have to make the tough calls, and I think she'll do that.
All right, we will leave it there. Former Los Angeles Mayor Antonio Villaraigosa, newly named Infrastructure Czar here in the state of California. We appreciate your time here on Inside California Politics.
Nikki, thank you for having me.